Today we are going to discuss the avalanche breakdown and the Jainer breakdown. Okay, when the voltage across the reverse bias p-n junction is increased, to a certain value called the breakdown voltage, like we are having. We are having p-n junction. And we are making it reverse bias. And there is a microammeter to measure the current. This voltage is, if it is variable, reverse bias is variable, and you note down the current which is in microamperes. At certain value of the voltage, suddenly the current rises. Okay? Current increased to a certain value called breakdown voltage. High reverse current is caused, which may damage the junction diode. If the diode is ordinary diode, it may damage. But if it is a Jainer, then there's no problem. So along this side is a forward biasing, forward VI curve. Here it is a VI curve for the reverse biasing. So there are two type of breakdown regions: avalanche effect and the Jainer effect. We to study when avalanche effects takes place, when Jainer breakdowns takes place. So there are two mechanisms: Jainer breakdown and avalanche breakdown. Now first of all, we are coming the Jainer breakdown. When the reverse biasing across the junction is increases, electric field at the junction also increases, because you know junction is reverse bias and there is no majority current. Current is because of the leakage current into the minority carriers. So as we are increasing the voltage across the junction, E also increases, because electric field is equals to potential over distance. And if the electric field is sufficient, if electric field is too strong, that it breaks the covalent bonds. Like electric field is, you know, the role of electric field is pulling the carriers from the bonds. The carriers are coming out of the bonds because of high electric field. There are no collisions of the carrier with the bonds or with the other carriers. Only the carriers are generating, because electric field is sufficient, pulling up the carriers from the bonds. Thus, what happens? A large number of carriers becomes available and are generated. And they causes a very large amount of current to flow. This mechanism of the breakdown is known as the Jainer breakdown. Jainer breakdown will occur when p-n junction is heavily doped. If it is heavily doped, depletion region will be very, very thin. So due to which the depletion region will be very narrow. If the depletion region is very narrow, then electric field is equals to potential over distance. As the D is very small, E becomes very high. So E becomes very high. So very high value of electric field pulls out the carrier from the covalent bonds. This mechanism firstly explained by the scientist Jainer. Hence it is given a name, Jenner breakdown. Now we are coming to the second breakdown called the avalanche breakdown. In case of avalanche breakdown, the barrier electric field, because p-n junction is reverse biased, so there is no current due to the majority carriers, but the field is sufficient, electric field is sufficient to accelerate the minority carriers. The minority carrier which are generated in the depletion region because of the heat or the thermal energy, they are accelerated to a very high velocity, and they break the other covalent bonds. They break the covalent bonds and hence generating more carriers, and again generated more carriers are further accelerated. New generated carrier are again further accelerated by the electric field, and again they break more covalent bonds, and this process repeats on, and ultimately it becomes a chain reaction is established. And this chain reaction, you know, is established, and very large number of carriers becomes available, and a very high current is produced. This is known as avalanche breakdown. So they are the main important facts about the breakdown mechanisms as avalanche breakdown. For avalanche breakdown, no need of heavy doping, lightly doped p-n junction. With lightly doped, what happened, the depletion region becomes wider. So if this is wider p-n junctions, if the wider depletion region, then there are carriers, minority carriers, they are generated by thermal energy, they get a chance to accelerate. And doping density controls the breakdown voltage. Now one thing is more, the temperature coefficient of the avalanche mechanism is positive. Now what it means? It means that as the temperature increases, so the reverse breakdown voltage also increases. So if the temperature is high, reverse breakdown voltage will be high. The magnitude of the temperature coefficient also increases with the increasing breakdown voltage, because the different material having different breakdown voltage. And then the temperature coefficient depends upon the magnitude of that, depends upon the what is the breakdown voltage. Now next, second Jenner breakdown. Jenner breakdown occur in a heavily doped p-n junctions only, because depletion region becomes extremely thin and E becomes quite high. So thin, that those carrier cannot accelerate, because the depletion region is thin, the carrier not getting a chance to excel for acceleration. But as E is quite high, so with the depletion so thin, the quantum mechanical tunneling through the layers occur, causing current to flow. If it is too thin, then the another effects, the tunneling effects, it may occur. And one thing is important to understand, temperature coefficient of the Jenner mechanism is negative. It is the other way of the Jenner breakdown. The breakdown voltage for a particular diode decreases with the increasing temperature. Now for the Jenner, you know, Jenner effect. And Jenner diode, either or both breakdown mechanisms may present at low doping level and high voltage. The avalanche mechanism dominates, while at the heavy doping levels and lower voltage, the Jenner mechanisms dominate. Okay, thank you.